Hey, good afternoon, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. Got a big update on what's going on with Rafael. We just had newly formed tropical storm Rafael. It is at 47 miles per hour sustained winds. It is moving north at 7 miles per hour. It's bringing more hurricane force winds towards the Cayman Islands as it's going to strengthen. It's going to be 86 miles per hour sustained winds going towards Cuba, strengthening to a Cat 2 hurricane of 98 miles per hour sustained winds, 121 miles per hour wind gusts. Still strong on the other side of Cuba of 92 miles per hour. Then it's going to get hit with the dry air, and dwindle down to barely a low-grade hurricane, and eventually curve a little bit with the system. Where it goes, it really doesn't matter, because it's going to go from 75 miles per hour storm down to a 58 or lower miles per hour storm, and then probably nothing after that. Now, right now, there is a tropical storm warning out for Jamaica still, and you can see how you got 39 miles per hour sustained winds at least hitting across Jamaica, and you can see where this line is going across from one loop to the other of the sustained winds covering almost the whole island with at least 39 miles per hour sustained winds. So you can just say almost all the island except the eastern side. You still got the feeder bands that's going to be coming on, bringing you the strong banding and the flooding from the eastern side as well. Now this is going to go up towards Cayman Islands. You're still in a hurricane warning. Also for western Cuba, you're in a hurricane watch right now and a tropical storm watch. Now do you have tropical storm watch out for Florida Keys also. Thank you for your time, everybody. I appreciate you tuning in. Please help me share this information to other people so you know exactly what's going on with this storm. Thank you so much. Let's get into the video. So you see the latest on intensity guidance showing it as it goes by the Cayman Islands, as it goes by Cuba. It will be a strengthening potential hurricane to a high-end Cat 1, right on the edge of a low-end Cat 2. As it crosses by Cuba, you can see where it starts weakening down, starts going to where the water temperatures are right at 80 degrees or getting cooler, and you have the dry air and the shear. And this is bringing it all the way from a quickly down from a low-end Cat 1 down to that tropical storm and that tropical depression just really quickly. But you can see the majority of them in automatic tropical cyclone forecast that it goes in this direction, and we do get a little bit of a wobble and comes back more than likely as it's going by Jamaica. You still have your high pressure right here guiding everything clockwise, making that system go further towards the west, right over Cuba. Now, once it gets over Cuba, you can see your positioning of your high pressure is right on the edge of Florida. And that's going to bring it more around, but then it's by itself. It's not being held by the trough. It's not being held by the high pressure. And it's just sitting there between two upper level highs. You got a high right here. You got a high right here. And it's just keeping it in that standstill motion, just getting sheared, dry aired, and just wobbles into nothing. All the heavy precipitation is going to come off and go across the southeast. It's going to get ripped right off and bring all the heavy rainfall. And you can see from the sea surface temperatures, all this bright orange to gold color, this is right at 80 degrees Fahrenheit. You need 80 degrees to sustain a tropical system. Now, as it moves further towards the north, it's going to start in doing that shear, that dry air. So now it's going to get into this system and get into the core and greatly weaken it. And then it's going to move across towards the cooler waters over here, the bright yellow. And it's just not going to have nothing left, especially with the cooler waters, the shear and the dry air, showing the shear will attack it. As soon as it goes into the Gulf, it's going to start weakening down. When it goes in that little western wobble, it gets hit with a lot amount of shear. Look at this. It even knocks it all the way down into nothing while all the precipitation is over here. It gets pretty close towards Jamaica, becomes that tropical storm, goes by the Cayman Islands, still strengthening up, becomes a hurricane as it goes by Cuba. See, that's a little eastern on Cuba. But look how it goes further on that little S wobble to the west, then back to the north right there. But look how quickly that shear just knocks that down, the cold water, the dry air, don't bring anything. Now that's the GFS. Look at the hurricane models showing it does strengthen up right past Jamaica, Cayman Islands, goes to Cuba, and look at this, wobbles right towards Louisiana. and then weakens down. See how quickly that weakens down? Right there is getting hit with all that cooler water. So now it's sucking up very cold water, and it's just stopping any thunderstorm growth, and it's killing that system. All the precipitation is off to the east, and now it's really weakening down. Nothing left to that. B shows the exact same thing for everyone in the Caribbean, and it shows it could wobble a little bit further to the west. Could make landfall as a weak tropical storm, and then go right by New Orleans, right by southern Mississippi with that system. But still, all the precipitation is going to be getting sheared to the east. So you can see this here with GFS. So as that system heads north, now you got your dry air coming in, you got your shear weakening it down, and your dry air is going all the way in towards the core. Look at this, it gets hit so hard, there's nothing left to that. All the precipitation is way over here to the east, and there's just nothing left to that system. Just sheared up while it just dies off to the west. Latest rainfall amounts are the same for Nicaragua and Honduras. It has gone up to Jamaica, where you got your isolated of 8 inches on eastern Jamaica. It did swing around towards Kingston, towards southern Jamaica, all the way towards southwestern Jamaica with 150 to 200 millimeters. And it did stretch all the way across from west to east across the island of the 150 to 100 millimeters to 4 to 6 inches. So a lot of heavy rainfall is definitely coming for you. And you still have those feeder bands that's going to be coming across the islands as well, so watch out for those. You do see it did raise up for northern Cayman Islands as well, got you up to 6 inches plus. Also for western Cuba, it's big track of heavy rainfall showing so far. Wind gusts will pick up definitely as you go by the northern half of the Cayman Islands. All that orange to red goes from 50 to 60 miles per hour wind gusts. Then it goes by Cuba, starts bringing over 80, 90 miles per hour wind gusts in that red. Then it goes by Florida Keys, and it brings some winds towards y'all a little bit as well. Further west this goes, the more you won't even notice. Look, right before landfall, it weakens down into nothing. Worst case scenario, this whole area right here of the red to the orange, the 50 to 60 miles per hour wind gusts, this could actually get on shore just a little bit more. Showing the heavy rainfall, so even though the storms are going in this direction, it's getting sheared over towards the east. So a landfall storm going towards Louisiana or Mississippi would impact Alabama and Georgia and the Panhandle of Florida with all this heavy rainfall. And you see it going through Cayman Islands, also Jamaica, over Cuba. Now, when you look with the Euro, this is only the next 5 days. Look at the Euro. It's showing the same thing. Even though the Euro is showing that westward track, because it's going to be a weaker system, it's going to be a stronger high pressure. And this high pressure on the southwest is what's going to steer it to the west. But it's still showing all this heavy precipitation over here for the southeast. And showing if it continues on that westward track, it could also bring more for y'all and for Texas, Louisiana, and Arkansas. And you can see this here. Latest run, it brings it right to the west. This high pressure lets go of it. This upper level high over here towards eastern Pacific and Mexico spins that to the west. It stays on good strength because it's going over warmer waters. It's not going towards the cooler waters. And it stays strong all the way towards the western side of the Gulf of Mexico. Now remember, we still have that deep ocean heat over here that's helping this become a good little tropical storm over here for Jamaica. And after that passes and goes into Western Caribbean, it still get into a little bit of the warm temperatures. The warmest is far Western Caribbean. I don't think it's going to be able to tap into that. Thank you for your time, everybody. Hope this video has helped you in some way understand what is going on with the storm. I will keep you updated. Make sure it stays on the same track that it is forecasted. I appreciate every single one of y'all. Now, before you go for the evening, 2 Corinthians verse 4, 1 through 6. Therefore, seeing we have this ministry, as we have received mercy, we faint not, but have renounced the hidden things of dishonesty, not walking in craftiness, nor handling the word of God deceitfully, but by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. But if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, in whom the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. For we preach not ourselves, but Christ Jesus the Lord, and ourselves your servants for Jesus' sake. For God, who commanded the light to shine out of the darkness, hath shined in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. Amen. Have a great night, everybody. May God be with every single one of y'all. And remember, all glory goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.